What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So I was looking back at my videos from when I did like iOS 12 videos, and I realized the iPhone 7 Plus, you know, a lot of people wanted to see updated iOS reviews on it. And I've done the iPhone 8 Plus, the iPhone 8s and all those. So, and I figured since the 7 and the 7 Plus are a lot different than the 6S and 6S Plus, I might as well talk about the 7 Plus as well, throw it in these reviews as well, and, you know, kind of show a little bit of love to it as well. This was my daily driver at one point, my main phone, my main squeeze. I use this phone like literally every single day. Now, there are a couple changes with iOS 13 beta 2, and actually there's a lot of them. This update was about 620 megabytes on my iPhone 7 Plus. So for like a full OS release, not a huge update, but considering the fact that this is mostly bug fixes and improvements in that sense, no features added, this is a pretty substantial update in my opinion. Now, one of the best features of iOS 13 beta 2 isn't even necessarily a feature of it, but more so what Apple did for this specific beta, and that is the ability that we can now actually install updates. I stuttered so much there. But we can install updates now through a beta profile, so we don't necessarily need to download it on our MacBook or Windows or whatever and install from iTunes. We can now actually go download a profile straight on our phone and just download it from our phone like a software update, you know, like iOS 12.3.1 update or something. So just like how we used to do it on iOS 12, I'm so freaking happy about that. As you can see, I have the iOS 13 profile here. I am an Apple developer, so I had to get it through Apple themselves, but I've seen other links there too, so you can just kind of play with it however you want to. But that is really, really cool, and I'm so happy about that. Another small thing that I saw is if you see this dock on the bottom, before on beta 1, that actually was the same color. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't going to the dark mode like on my iPhone 10 or whatever, but now on the 7 Plus and other phones with IPS panels, you can now see that it is dark, so I'm so happy Apple did that. And like I said, this update was pretty much predicated on bug fixes, so there weren't like too many features added, but one of the main ones that were added was actually audio sharing. So now you can go and, you know, let's say you want to share audio with an AirPod device and also like PowerBeats, you now have that ability to do so with iOS 13 beta 2. On beta 1, I guess that wasn't applicable, but on beta 2, you have that ability now, so I'm really happy about that. And here's the weird thing. You know how I tell you, you know, don't install this version of iOS, you know, wait until the public beta? Well, it turns out that we were initially supposed to see the public beta at the end of July, so like, you know, July, whatever, 30th or whatever, but it turns out Apple is actually supposed to be pushing the public beta later this month, so in a couple weeks. Now, in my opinion, I think this might be a typo because maybe they thought beta 2 or beta 3 was going to come, you know, later on in July. So they would just simply add that piece of text there, so then people would be like, okay, that makes sense. But maybe it is coming sooner than scheduled, so that'd be really, really cool for the people who don't want to install this beta profile. They can wait until the public beta, which is going to be the same thing as beta 3 or beta 4, so. But at least we have that ability, which is going to be freaking awesome. Now, I did run a benchmark on an iOS 13 beta 1, I had a multi-core score of 194,773, and I just reran it, and it did actually go down 9,000 points to 185,661. Now, is it that big of a deal? You know what? Not really. You know, this is a beta, so we're going to see a lot of improvements in the benchmark and also decreases in the benchmark. It's not the end of the world, honestly. Like I've said before, I would give up a little bit of speed on my phone to gain back some stability. So the fact that Apple is focusing on these bug fixes and everything, you know, quite possibly it could mean that the score is going to go down, but that score is just a score. That doesn't necessarily mean the phone is getting faster or slower. It just means on that specific benchmark, that was the case. Of course, you know, that could mean that the phone is getting slower or faster, but in my case, I mean, I'm not really too bitter about it. Again, this is a beta, so we have to wait till the official version to make that, you know, oh, iOS 13 is slower than iOS 12 or whatever. So I will have an updated review in a couple days talking about my experience with iOS 13 beta 2 on my main device, so stick around for that one. But that's pretty much it. Like I said, don't install iOS 13 yet. Wait until the public beta at the very earliest. But I guess we're gonna have to wait to the public beta on my opinion on that. But that's pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much. But definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. All those links are linked down below. I would really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. And hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.